This is Veana Marie, and you're listening to Hoobazoo.com.
At Audios, our engineers have created a breakthrough in wireless loudspeakers. We developed a new way to experience sound. Audios, the future of loudspeakers.
Hi, I'm Eric Young, the co-founder and CEO of Audios, and we're building the first fully wireless loudspeakers for venues and event spaces.
With Audios, all you have to do is place the speakers where you want them and press the power button. The speakers automatically build their own wireless network, connect to each other, and start streaming. That means you have zero cables and zero cable replacements. A 300-person event that would take 1 hour to set up only takes 10 minutes with Audios. Our wireless speaker doesn't need Bluetooth or Wi-Fi router and has 2 patents granted. To learn more, go to republic.co/audios. For a limited time only, anyone can invest and become a part owner.
The following conversation is real. It took place on Tuesday, June 8th of 2004 between a Blonde Star advisor and a subscriber.
Blonde Star emergency, this is Steve. Is there an emergency in your vehicle?
Oh my God. I've locked myself in my car and the keys are on the outside.
Ma'am.
Oh my God.
Ma'am, I need you to calm down.
Okay, it's just that the windows are rolled up and I'm starting to sweat. My keys are on the outside.
Now, your keys are on the outside of the vehicle?
Yes, oh my God.
Now, does your car have automatic locks or...
Yes.
Okay, here's what I need you to do. Take hold of the inside of your door handle there. Are you doing this? The shiny thing. Grab the shiny thing.
Okay, I've got it.
Okay, now give that a tug.
Okay.
Did it open?
Yes, oh my God, thank you.
Okay, now what is that noise?
Oh, that's my door alarm.
Yeah, but that only happens if the keys are in the ignition, hun.
Oh my God. You know what?
Your keys are actually in your ignition.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my God, thank you so much, Blonde Star.
That's why we're here. Do you need anything else?
Blonde Star.
No, that's
always
it.
On, because you're always blonde.
Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
Blasphemy! This is madness! This is the booth!
Staring down, looking at the blood-stained concrete. You're the dead MC, blind at my feet. You took a 9mm rhyme straight to your mind. Damn, I better split. These witnesses my time, so I make my way up the block. Get to home base and lock that up. Crack the Cavassier and grab the phone. Call one of my troops up. Hope the soldier's homie says, yo, what's up, what's going on? Make it quick, cause I'm trying to get my stellar on. Nigga, your girl, I'm in the... These lyrical assassins tried to pull a hit, and then boom, came a noise from the other room. It was the boys in blue with the SWAT crew. They got us locked up for lyrical murder. It's one of them charges that you never heard of. It's the booth. The booth. The booth. The booth. Yeah, it's the booth. The booth. The booth. The booth. Yeah, we're killing all your podcasts like the HIV virus. You want to battle this kid? Huh, don't even try this. Back the up, think again, count to 10. You want to grab that mic just to get done in? It's the booth. The booth. The booth. The booth. Yeah, it's the booth. The booth. The booth. The booth. Yeah, it's the booth.
Was he African?
African.
No. He was American, and he was like you. He looked just like you.
He was Jewish.
Just Wait, like
okay.
him.
Okay, Jew. It's an odd crime for a Jew to commit.
Yeah, I'm pretty docile.
Okay, so we have an African Jew wearing a hoodie.
No, you don't.
No.
No, that's not what I said. Is that what you heard me say? I said he looked like you. Do you look like an African Jew?
No, I look like a cop.
Yeah.
He was Caucasian.
All right, your boy Sins to One Broadcasting Live. We are back here in the booth, and I believe we've got the stream connected to him. It sounds like we're good. He can hear me now. No delay. We should be on point there. Refresh the stream. Everybody's back with us. and Goonie Goo. Let's get this back off going again. So the release is called Till They Come and Get Me. It's a mixtape, four tracks, four producers. You want to shout out the producers you work with on this?
Let's get a quick corrections there. Until They Come Get Me, that's the name of that single.
Okay.
The project is actually called Trap Miz.
Okay.
On Trap Miz, I'm working with numerous producers, but just to shout out a few, shout out Peter Beats, shout out Jay Clay on the track, shout out Pillar Productions. That's just a few to name. I mean, I work with a few producers, so I'm all over the place. I'm working on a mix CD, EP, and an album all at the same time.
What was the inspiration for this whole entire project for you this time around under COVID?
For Trap Miz or everything?
Yeah. Pretty much, to be honest, everything, because a lot of people have been locked down for the last year. So a lot of people have put some stuff out. You put some stuff out in December. So what has been your inspiration? What has been your thing that you've done during COVID to get this locked down so you could put out the best project possible?
I mean, honestly, there wasn't no inspiration. I just kept on working. So COVID didn't really affect me. Mm-hmm. I mean, I understand that it's a very, hefty topic and everything. It's something very serious. But I didn't let COVID stop anything. I just kept on pushing.
And do you feel like, because I know there's a lot of artists during this time that, you know, they kind of fell in a rut. Some people are putting out, you know, tough music right now. Some people are putting out some stuff out there that's like, you know, on point. You know, we just got some new music right off the bat from Eminem. You know, we got a lot of people that are just steady grinding. So for you, you stay grinding. You put this project out because you wanted to let people know that you didn't want to fall off. You wanted to stay busy and put this out there. For this project that you just put out there, what do you feel is the closest to you for the inspiration for this project?
Well, correction. The project ain't releasing. The mix CD ain't released until May 5th.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, as far as the EP and the album, that's released the end of the year. Mm-hmm. But just to keep it on track, Miz, right now and everything, I mean, the inspiration, everything that came from that, as far as inspiration, the focusness and everything, it was just that I haven't put no music out in a while, so it was time. I was overdue. Just to let the world in on me a little bit. I just came home from a 6-year prison bid. I've been home for 2 years, so I was due. I was due to give the world some more music. So that's what's going on.
So you're fully focused on this project, Trap Bands, right now. So you're trying to keep that steady, keep that going, and then you're going to hit everybody else with this other stuff later on. You've got an attack plan for that when that comes?
Yes, yes I do. So I'm going to drop Trap Bands May 5th, 2021. And then after Trap Miz, with a few months after May, I'm going to drop the EP. And then after the EP, I'm going to release the album. So I'm releasing everything this year.
And with the shows and stuff coming back, are you anxious to get back out there and perform? Because I know a lot of people have been waiting for it. Are you ready?
hey, listen, right? Again, correction. I ain't never did stop, man. So when everybody wasn't doing no shows, Goonie still was doing shows, man. I was still moving.
Well, you know, a lot of people was doing it online or whatever, but I mean, still.
Hey, listen, right? I was doing it live. I was still jumping on a jet, man. I was still gone.
All right. Look at you.
Miami, man. Just performed down Miami. It was all love. It was definitely all love, man. I went down there, man, represented. I did two shows in two different occasions down there. I was up for Tampa for Super Bowl weekend. I mean, I still been moving around, man. I still been doing what I got to do to make it happen with this music thing and everything. So, like I said, I didn't let COVID interrupt with anything. I was still going to studios, still doing interviews, still doing live shows and everything. I mean, it wasn't too much going on in my city because my city, it was completely shut down.
Right.
But I was still going to other states handling my business.
and you held it down. So that's a good rep for this project and keeping it going. So you stayed busy with this stuff that you did and kept going. That's great. That's great stuff. Any experiences that you want to talk about that kind of got you going this period? Because for you, you did a lot more than a lot of artists did not do. So for you, what was your big exposure? What was your biggest moment during this time that you utilized?
My biggest moments was just being able to do what I have to do, man, because understand that at one point in time when I first came home 2 years ago, I wasn't allowed to leave the state.
Right, right.
Due to court situations and everything. So after putting in the motion for me to leave and everything, I was off and running, man. I said, listen, when I finished that 6 years 2 years ago, I said, listen, when I get the chance to be able to jump on that jet and go, I'm going to go full force and I ain't stopping. And ever since I won that motion in courts for me to be able to travel, I haven't stopped yet, man.
And that's a positive story. And for a lot of guys out there, you know, for you, you kept it going, you moved it forward, you're progressing. So I want you to kind of talk to some of these dudes who keep falling in the same rut. And then when you talk to them, they say that stuff is impossible. You're already showing that it's not impossible. If you got your grind on, you got your mentals right, you can progress. You can move forward. Because you know how some dudes, they have that excuse. So I want you to talk right to them.
It's not even really an excuse. It's like, I mean, I understand that everybody comes from different backgrounds in life and everything. But see, me, I was taught that if you want something, you go out and get it, man, nonstop. No excuses at all. You know what I'm saying? Just go. Just get it. Just chase it down. And when it comes down to talking about your dreams and your goals and everything, there ain't no stopping. There ain't no quitting. There ain't no nothing. You just got to keep going. Keep it pushing. Don't give up. Just stay humble. Stay consistent. Whatever you want to do in life. You know what I'm saying? Not even just music. You know what I'm saying? But you just got to keep it going, man. And that's your dream. That's your goal. So you believe in that. You got to believe in yourself. And so that's what I do. I believe in myself. You know what I'm saying? I believe that I still could make it happen in the music industry. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm not nowhere near in the state of mind of stopping or quitting. I'm all in.
So all positivity, just keep looking forward. It's about you and what you're invested in and not going back. You know, you're about you. And that's you got to be that way to stay focused in this game, you know, and not put up with the BS and some of the stuff that happens out here. So I applaud you for that one, because, you know, it's a lot of dudes, they come out and, you know, it's sad because things happen and dudes end up back in. So it's great to see that you're progressing, you're moving forward, you're living your dream and doing this positive thing through music. And I give more power to you for that. So for you, do you have any videos that you might be working on that you might be coming out with this project?
I'm definitely working on a video. I'm actually sometime this week, actually, it was spoken about with a few of my team members and everything. We're about to shoot the Till They Come and Get Me video. So we're in the beginning stages of that, but we're hoping to get started on that within the next few weeks. I mean, nice outside.
I'm looking for warmer weather's coming. Yep.
Yes.
When it comes to your music videos, how much hands-on are you? Do you let your team handle that project, or do you bring the ideas?
Both. It's like a round table type of thing. So it's like, I don't just have a team and just for me to say at the end of a meeting or anything, well, the heck with it. We go do it my way, and this is the way I want it. I like advice. I like input. You feel what I'm saying? And I utilize that from the ones that's part of my everyday circle. For the ones that's been there since day one and haven't stopped yet. You feel what I'm saying? So, I mean, we put it down together. You know, say I might say I want a red and a black car in the video. The team might say, well, why not have two black cars in the video? Then it's like, okay, well, we ain't gonna stay here and debate on that, you know? Like, okay, cool. Well, we gonna have two black cars in the video, you know what I'm saying? Like, so I mean, you know, it's a team effort over here, you know what I'm saying? I work together with my team. I take heed to what they saying and how they feel that I should make my next move, you know what I'm saying? I mean, that's how I learned how to play chess, you know what I'm saying, with the OGs, man. You know what I'm saying? They're like, yo, listen, don't push the pawn over there. Push the horse over here. So I'm like, well, I think I should push the pawn. But when I pushed that horse, you know what I'm saying, I became a winner. So right. I'm a person that, take advice and everything, you know?
All right. Cool. So what I like to do sometimes, I like to let the artists kind of let their hair down, let people know some things. So if we had to come at you as an artist, give us something that a lot of people really don't know about Goonie Goo as an artist that you can share with us. It could be funny. It could be whatever you want. Just something that a lot of people are going to be like, oh, shoot, I didn't know that about this cat.
I mean, you know, that's like, I don't know how to answer that question because I'm a straightforward person. Mm-hmm. I let it all be known. Like, there's no hidden secrets around here. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like, I let it all out. I give you my all. As soon as you're on the doorsteps, man. As soon as I open the door, it's everything. I lay it right there. So I do that because it gives you the option if you want to deal with me as a person mm-hmm. or not. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Like,
right.
We build a friendship or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I give it all up front. So with Goonie, there's no hidden secrets. You feel what I'm saying? Like, this is me. This is what you're going to get right here. I'm going to give it to you straight raw. However, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is, you know?
And because I got you on here today, I got to ask you this because you are a fellow artist. Today, as you guys see behind me, marks the 24th anniversary. We lost a legend in rap. A legend. I don't care what anybody has to say. We lost Biggie Smalls, and the entire industry went quiet. Quiet. There was no questions asked. I want to ask you about how did Biggie touch you as an artist as far as his career, as far as his raps. I want to know how he affected you as an artist, and the day of his passing, how did that affect you? Because a lot of people can remember that day when they got the word, man. It was rough.
I mean, when I look at Biggie's situation and Biggie not being here with us today, I look at myself. So it's like Biggie was hot, man. Biggie was fire. Biggie was hip hop. And when I look at that situation, the before and the after, I look at my situation because, for the simple fact is, I start to feel like I'm the Biggie of my city. Mm-hmm. So when I say that is, the hate is real, man. And there was somebody that couldn't accept Biggie for what Biggie was about to do to the music game. So I look at myself and feels the same way at times. So as far as the effect parts is, like, I sit here and write music. I sit here and say to myself, damn, I got to hurry up and drop this mix CD, drop this song album and everything before they come and get me. Because that's how I feel. Because me coming from where I came from, I know that the hate is real. A lot want to know how and why and who the hell is Goonie. So it's like Goonie just came home. So how the hell is Goonie career is further than our career? So instead of acceptance, and when I say acceptance, that's like accepting who you are as mm-hmm, a person.
Mm-hmm. Right. And
right. You know, maybe you just didn't want it like Goonie wanted it. You know what I'm saying? So why get mad at me? Why hate on me? You know what I'm saying? And right now, I'm talking about my city. I'm talking about the city that I reside in, Massachusetts, Boston. You know what I'm saying? Like, why get mad at me? Why hate on Goonie? Because Goonie's doing what he's supposed to be doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, it's enough out here for everybody. And if any artist just stay consistent and in their lane, they could get further in their career also. But see, I'm dealing with a city that just don't know how to appreciate and support. It is what it is. I'm calling it like it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's like, I got a phone call the other day. They said, hey, Goonie, you almost dead, man. I said, thanks. This individual says, so listen, when you get there, are you coming back for the city? I said, no. I said, see, I've wasted years dealing with my city when it comes down to music. I'm not a new jack to the music scene at all, especially not in my city. I have 2 decades in with music in my city. But due to my street affiliations and in and out of incarcerations, my career, my goal, my dream was slowed down. But now I'm here to stay. So what I'm saying is, I don't get no support, man. I don't feel the love. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, why am I coming back? Don't get me wrong. There are a few artists in the city that I wouldn't mind working with. There are a few artists in the city that I wouldn't mind breaking bread with. But see, the thing with me right now, I'm at your energy levels. So if you're not a 7-day artist, we can't do nothing, man. I do this 7 days a week. Regardless if I do it for 2 hours or straight 10 hours or straight 24 hours, I do this 7 days a week, no days off. If I'm not writing music, I'm listening to beats. If I'm not listening to beats, writing music, I'm networking. If I'm not networking, listening to beats, writing music, I'm doing interviews. 7 days a week, I'm doing something with music. No days off.
Hard work LA, no days off. You got the same thing. And it's funny you talk about that because I've always talked about how Boston has been this way for a long time. Way, way back in the day, Guru had to leave Massachusetts and go to New York because Guru couldn't get his shine. And he was one of the most talented rappers out there. And Guru, a gangsta, took off, went to New York. He was living out in Attleboro. Why? Because he was getting no love here. We just recently saw this whole thing go down where I was kind of disgusted at how Joyner Lucas was treated. You don't have to like Joyner Lucas's music, but at the end of the day, Joyner Lucas was putting Massachusetts on the map in the rap game. And when he came here to shoot a video, there was all types of hate against this man for trying to shoot a video out in Worcester. Tumble, well, that ain't really Boston. Hey, it don't matter. The point is that he came back here to shoot a video to try to represent and get some love. And all this, I don't know, it aggravates me sometimes. All this hate came out against Joyner Lucas. And I was like, why? Like, I couldn't get it. You know, it's... You know, this is a man that did exactly what we want to see for Boston, for Massachusetts as a whole. And then you have this ignorance and hate that just, you know, it's crazy, man. It's crazy and it bugs the hell out of me that we have this here. And it's not just Boston. This is other places too, but Boston has been known about it for a while.
Well, when we start talking about artists in Boston, like, it's bigger than Boston. First and foremost, it's New England. And then when we speak about New England, we start talking about the surrounding areas. So when I heard about Joyner Lucas, I didn't look at Joyner Lucas as a Worcester cat. I didn't look at Millie's as a Cambridge cat. You know what I'm saying? I looked at them. They from the Massachusetts state. You know what I'm saying? They from Mass. It's just, I don't know, with New England, it's just, the music scene is just like off, man. And if we was to just come together and support one another, we could have the spotlight, man. Like, literally, like, when I leave the state, like, listen, I've been leaving the state of Massachusetts since I was a kid. I wasn't the corner hustler dude that was hustling on the corner with 15 of my homeboys. I'll leave and go elsewhere. So I've been traveling for years. Mm-hmm. So point of me saying that is, when I travel, it's all love for Boston, man. It's all love for Massachusetts. Like, literally, like, the love is there. Like, all that animosity that a lot of cats got against different states, I never understood it. Like, a lot of people in the city got grudges against different states. And a lot of these cats never even left Massachusetts to have a grudge against another state. You know what I'm saying? Let's just keep this real. Like, we go talk about it. So
yeah,
it's like,
go for it. Yeah.
Like, everybody, so not, I'm, you know what? I'm not going to say everybody, but majority is so stuck on this, this Ray Benzino, Ray Dog theory thing, that where, like, they feel that they could just have a grudge with different people from different states and everything. Like, nah, man, like, what happened back in the day with the whole Ray Dog, all that soul movement thing with them traveling and, you know, acting like they want to punch whoever or whatever in the mouth and get put on and everything. I mean, so be it. But that was back then. We in 2021 now. So it's like, what's the hate for? You know what I'm saying? Like, I done been plenty of places, plenty of states, man. I done traveled. Mm-hmm. And there's hate everywhere. But the most hate is right here in my city, man. Like, the city. And when I say this, when I use the term city, I'm referring to Massachusetts.
Exactly, yep.
I'm not referring to Boston. That's just my term. That's the goonology mm-hmm. things. You know what I'm saying? Right. So when I'm saying, why do my city got a hate for? I mean, it's enough for everybody. You know what I'm saying? If you just get up off your ass and just go grind for it, man, you could get it, man. You know? And it's just sad. So therefore, I just take myself nowadays. I don't focus on that. I focus on self. There was times where I used to focus on other artists, try to help other artists. And I don't know everything. Let's not get that twisted. I don't know everything. Mm-hmm. But what I do know, I share. What I do have as far as connections, I share. Because if I can't go, maybe you could go. And I'm just hoping that you know, just shout me back out, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, hey, coach, step him back in. You know what I'm saying? like that, man. But you know what? Nobody know how to work like that in the city, man. Everybody's just like, I talk to the city daily on social media. And I just hear everybody's stories. And there's a lot of messed up feelings towards each other and pillow talking and bite, however you want to say it, man. But everybody's against each other, man. So it's like, I don't want to be part of that. So now that Goonie's home, you know what Goonie about to do? Goonie been looking to move out of state. I got to go.
Right.
Because I want to be part of this. This ain't the winners. Nobody here want to win. I need to be around winners. I need to be around good inspiration. I don't want to be around the phone calls like, yo, man, yeah, you heard that show, and yeah, man, I don't want to be around none of that, bro. Like, let's support each other. Let's help each other. You know what I'm saying? Let's uplift each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, man. I don't get it. Sometimes I be lost with it. But you know what? Sometimes I be like, yo, Goonie, you can't worry about the city. Worry about you. Just go. Because the city's not worried about you.
Look, I got to give you props for coming out here and giving us the positive, the right from the heart. Right from the heart. We got people, a lot of people in the chat. I got a Joey King. He said, talk that shit, Goonie. I got Kevin Jeffries of the Happy Hour with Lito Show. He said, join us, the homie. We got V Marie in the chat. What's next for Goonie? What's the next thing you got coming?
Hey, listen, I got some good features coming, man. I'm just going to talk about the features within my hometown, right?
Okay, all right, cool.
I got a major feature coming up with V Marie. Major. When I say major, major. I'm talking about, we didn't even lay this track down yet, and we already started talking about the visuals. Mm. Dope. Shout out to V Marie. I got some work going on with Carter Bartlier from No Attempts. Check him out. He's dope, definitely on his grind. He comes from the city. He's definitely holding the city down. I salute that man. Hey, me and him be talking, and I don't know how he do it, but how he be doing it, he's doing it, because he's dealing with the city. See, I don't deal with the city. But shout out to him, Carter Bartlier. hey, right? And that's all I'm working with in the city, man.
All right. So what I got to do, I got topics for my show. So I loved it, because you know a lot of stuff. And I got some topics here that you might be interested in talking with me about on the show tonight. So I was wondering if you'd be able to hang on with me and go over some of these topics.
Hey, I'm here.
Okay. All right. Let's get into the show right now. So getting into the news booth, as you guys see here, Veana Marie, reach out to her. All stream platforms, her music is available, VeanaMarie.com. She has a link tree on her Facebook page that will take you to all of her social media and all of her outputs and all of her outlets. So you want to make sure you reach out to her, VeanaMarie.com. Tonight, 8 o'clock, she actually has an exclusive two-part interview with Gangsta Gone Legit. Real spit. I can tell you right now, it's a fire interview. Part one airs tonight at 8 o'clock, so you guys want to make sure to jump on that. In the news booth, breaking news, classrooms will reopen April 5th and April 28th. They're going to stagger the kids going back to school. In my mind right now, why? Why? You send the kids to school April 5th. In a week or so, they go on April vacation. They come back from April vacation. They're winding down because grades close in May. Let's just, my feeling is, finish out the school year with the hybrid learning. And kick off September, going back to school, full blown. By then, everybody's vaccinated. Everything should have a great eyesight as to where we were with COVID-19. I think, why rush the kids back when they're only going back for 1 week of school, April vacation, and then grades close in May? This is something that I think, let's just take it slow. Take it slow. Let's see what's going on there. The CDC has given the red light. The APCSA has a food pantry coming up on March 21st, Sunday, at 8 a.m. If you have a dog or a cat that needs their rabies shot, you want to head down there. It's $15, and it's great stuff. CDC has given the green light for vaccinated grandparents to go visit grandkids. This is a big deal. It's not even young grandkids. Look, my dad had a diabetes issue, lost his foot, and my dad almost died. 2 months before COVID hit. Once COVID hit, my dad was considered one of those people that had, you know, a secondary condition, an underlying condition. So I haven't seen my dad in a year. There's some people who've lost their parents during this time and haven't seen them. My dad is, you know, he's older. You know, he's 70, he's 74. He'll be 75 this year. I haven't seen him in a year. I want to see my dad, you know, and I'm 50 years old. You know, so this whole thing about grandkids and look, you've got adult kids that haven't seen their parents or whatever. You know, you want to touch on that, man? Because
you there?
Yeah, I'm there. You want to touch on that?
I mean, that's a very touchy one right there. And just listening to you, I'm a diabetic myself.
Right. Yep. See. So. Yep.
And I still haven't took it serious. I still haven't paid attention to that type of lifestyle. I was discovered with diabetes when I went to prison, man. Going through the intake, they say, hey, you got sugar in your urine. I said, okay, what the hell that supposed to mean? So this is 2012 when I went in. Mm-hmm. What the hell that is, man? So next day they say, yeah, you go get called up to the infirmary, whatever, and everything, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, cool, I'll get to the infirmary. They say, hey, you a diabetic. I said, I'm a what? They said, you're a diabetic. I said, whoa, okay. I don't know nothing about that, but I heard about it. So long story short, I started off the insulin, and then I went to the pill. And I came home to the pill. But I'm a junk food eater, man, and all.
I feel you, because when my dad, what happened with my dad was that, you know, you got to take care of your feet. You got to take care of your extremities. And what happened was my dad had cut his foot while cutting his toenail. And then my dad, because he's stubborn, he's older. You know how it is with black men when they're older. They don't listen. And my dad ignored it. And that foot got infected to the point where he almost went septic and blew up. And my dad almost died. If it wasn't for my two boys who made my dad get in that ambulance, he probably would have died. So, you know, the diabetes is a big deal in the black community. And we really need to take care of ourselves.
And I'm just now recently paying attention, trying to pay attention, because so when a law head that I have diabetes, I get yelled at because a lot, you know, I be from social media to people that be around me every day, because I eat chicken 7 days a week if I can, fried chicken. So, you know, the cholesterol sky high from the grease and everything. So, and then I'm on my live every day eating snacks. Oh. Every day. So now it's like, I hear all these stories. And you would have thought that having the stories that I heard, that I would have got paid attention and got to it, handling my business. I didn't, but I'm just now getting into it because I have a close friend right now that is on the what's the machine called? What's the diabetes?
Dialysis.
Thing?
Dialysis.
And this friend don't look nothing the same, man. And me seeing him once a few weeks ago, kind of like shut me down a little bit. And it's all because he ain't pay attention to his diabetes. So when I see him hooked up the way he hooked up, I'm like, nah, that's not no place for Goonie, man. So now instead of the insulin, instead of the pill, I'm taking this other thing. It's like insulin, but it's not insulin. It's one of them little quick needles you could just, right, you know.
Right, yeah. Wow.
And things like that, you know what I'm saying? And I pay attention now. So I'm trying to lay off the junk food, man. I'm trying to substitute my chips and stuff for something like pretzels or something, because I know I won't smash a bag of pretzels, you know what I'm saying?
Right,
I'm trying to pay attention to more sugar-free candy in the grocery stores. I'm trying to leave the fried chicken alone, man, and go strictly baked chicken. You know, I mean, I'm still gonna have a cheat day. It is what it is. You know, I mean, I can't stop. It's not gonna happen overnight. You know what I'm saying? It's an addiction.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's an addiction. Every time I get shot with a dressing, go somewhere. I don't care if I'm going to my mama's house. I don't care if I'm going to a doctor's appointment. I don't care if I'm going to see probation. I got to stop at the gas station on the highway to grab me some snacks. So it's an addiction for me, but I'm fighting with it. And I know with the things that's going on with music and everything, and with me being more involved with music as far as shows and interviews and things like that, I know that I got to pay more attention to my health, man. I got to get being that healthy state of mind, because I don't want to be on stage somewhere passing out, dropping on the stage, and then here we go with all the reports on Goonie and the newspapers and magazines and everything. You know what I'm saying? So I'm now trying to stay fit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I'm working on that. Working on quitting these cigarettes, all that, man. Because this is my year right here. I'm definitely close to the industry, man. I'm definitely industry related right now. So I tell a lot of people that I'm winning, man. This is my year right here. So I got to make sure I'm prepared, because I know once I'm in, they're going to try to wear me out. So I got to be physically fit. I got to be stress free. You know what I'm saying? Because when I'm in there, you know what I'm saying? The only thing they going to do is just double what I'm doing right now. You know what I'm saying? So if I'm doing two shows a week right now, then once I'm in, I'm doing four shows a week. So I got to be prepared for that, man. You know what I'm saying? That's a lot of moving around and a lot of breathing control and stuff like that. So I got to leave these cigarettes alone. I know what I got to do. You know what I'm saying? I do acknowledge that and everything. And for the people, I ain't letting nobody down, man. This is it right here. That's why when I came home from finishing 6 years, I had to make a decision if I still wanted to play in the streets or if I wanted to go full-time, overtime with music. And I'm going full-time, overtime with music. You know what I'm saying? It was a beautiful day outside today, man. Beautiful day. Beautiful day outside today. I wish to be out there. Couple of people call me, say, hey, come on to the hood, let's throw dice and all this stuff. I said, you know what, I got an interview, man. Then after my interview, I got some beats to listen to, man, to finish up this project, man. That's what I gotta do, man. You know what I'm saying? So I'm here, man. So again, I'm not gonna let the people down. I got a lot of people in my corner. I got a lot of support. I got a lot of fans. And I ain't letting nobody down, man. You know what I'm saying? We gonna win. We to the top, man.
Nice. I'm glad you opened up. I appreciate you opening up with me. So we're going to continue on. We're going to move on into the legal booth. The right to work was defeated in Montana and Colorado. It's also going to be ended in New Hampshire. They're saying if you guys are up on union labor laws and stuff, this right to work was a scary law that was being passed. It's great to see this going down. Heading into the entertainment booth, well, let me close out the news with here with the last story. Bridgewater State food delivery workers are now robots. If you attend college at Bridgewater State and you place your order, they've got robots on wheels that are delivering your food now. This is crazy stuff. We saw New York Police Department just unleash the robo dogs on the streets of New York. So this time is coming, people. This time is coming. Again, entertainment booth, Real Spit from A Gangsta Gone Legit, episode 22, featuring Veana Marie tonight. Episode 1 of her interview, and we're going to be able to check that out. Also in the entertainment booth, Mortal Kombat, the movie, aims to have the best fight scenes ever on film. Now, back in the day, that first Mortal Kombat movie was ridiculous. Ridiculous. But to say that you're going to have the best fight scenes ever on film right now, look, I'm a big fan of Netflix Daredevil. And the Marvel shows, Daredevil had some crazy fight scenes. I'm a big fan of martial arts. Tony Jaa, all these cats, man. Mortal Kombat, that's a steep promise to make, man. That's a steep promise to make. Are you a fan of Mortal Kombat?
No.
I'm a big fan of that. I'm ready to see some fights.
I'm a Street Fighter fan, man.
Street Fighter the game or Street Fighter Sonny Chiba?
Sonny Chiba.
Oh! Yes. Sonny Chiba was nothing nice, man. He doesn't get the props that he should get. And I know everybody loves Bruce Lee, but when you talk about Bruce Lee, you got to talk about Sonny Chiba. He's right there with the Donnie Yens. He's there with the Tony Jaas. But Sonny Chiba was, he was a whole different style, a whole different caliber of martial arts, man. What was your favorite Sonny Chiba film?
It wasn't one. It wasn't no favorites for me.
Oh, you liked him just overall.
Overall. Just, it almost inspired me.
Uh-huh.
To be part of some, to get involved with some martial arts.
For real? Really? How come you never took that path?
You know, I'm in the streets. I'm all over the place. Music was my dream, so I didn't want to add another dream. I didn't want to do the, well, if music don't happen for you, what you going to do? But, nah, music's going to happen for me. I mean, I ain't know what I'm going to do. This is how music going to happen for me. So I didn't, you know, I didn't go forward with it. Just like, it was a question you asked, something about Goonie that nobody knows.
Yes, yes. I was asking you if there's something that people don't know, like the Sonny Chiba.
I was thinking about it, right?
Uh-huh.
When everybody look at me as an artist, a lot of people look at me as a controversy artist, first and foremost. It's cool. It is what it is. I'm Goonie.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So a lot of people didn't know Mark Wahlberg was the one to inspire me to do music.
Oh, for real?
So when they look at me and look at him, they be like, you're Goonie, you're from, hold on, whoa, just hold on, it ain't adding up. Well, actually, it does add up because Mark Wahlberg and his family is from where I grew up at.
Okay.
So I was there before the movies with Mark Wahlberg. I was there before the Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch, Feel the Vibration and everything. You know what I'm saying? I was there before all that.
Mm-hmm.
So now when he started creating what he created, when he first came about and everything, he actually taught me how to write a 16. And my inspiration came from over there.
What? Oh. So you never told nobody that? This is the first, pretty much?
I think I probably mentioned in another interview. I'm not sure, but that's what a lot of people don't know about Goonie.
Oh, shit. So he taught you your 16 how to set that? Really?
He taught me how to write it.
Wow. Wow. And that inspired you to do what you're doing today.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Because I didn't even think of Marky Wahlberg of teaching people. You know, I know he had his stuff going on, but, you know, his stuff hit so fast. His career was just crazy how that went, you know. And being somebody who was part of another success, you know, it was almost like he was destined for failure, but he didn't. He overcame everything, and he's where he's at today. You know, he had some struggle, but he was able to recoup, and wow.
Hey, that's that. You got to be humble in situations, man, and just stay consistent.
Wow.
If you stay consistent at whatever you want to do in life, eventually you're going to be a winner.
Mm-hmm. Consistency is definitely a key. So let me keep moving on here in the entertainment booth. For guys who don't know, Pepe Le Pew was called out for perpetrating rape culture. He has now been canceled. Pepe Le Pew is the skunk from the Looney Tunes. He's now been removed from the from the Space Jam 2 movie. This is craziness where you have things that are from back in the day, old school. It's being canceled because it just doesn't fit in this era. And on top of cancellations and talking about the music industry right now, 6 more women have come forward. We are now up to over 30 people who are accusing Tiny and T.I. of sexual assault. We are now going across state lines with this one. We now have a girl who was a minor. For one of the things that I've read and seen in some of this is these accusations are coming hard. They're coming fast. And with the interview that we just had with the Marilyn Manson survivor, is that behind the scenes, you know, behind the scenes, a lot of people don't realize that there's this freaky world out there behind the scenes where some of these people know what they're getting into. And what happens is you do some things that you don't want to do, or you do some things. And T.I. and his wife, Tiny, have said, oh, we've had these relationships with people, but they're saying this was all consensual. But we're up to 30 now. It's a crazy situation. Goon, you've been on the road. You've seen it. You know, you don't want to catch a case and go back. T.I., and for people who don't know, T.I. is already out on parole for these federal gun charges. So T.I. really don't need this. He don't need this type of stuff coming at him, because this is going to put him right back into jail, definitely. And Tiny, she's on TikTok like nothing's happening, and that's really hurting her character, because people are kind of like, they don't care. What are your thoughts on that?
My thoughts is like this, man. It's about your surroundings. And that's why my surroundings is minimal. But those type of reasons right there. Mm-hmm. Because the world we live in today, with the jealousy, envy, and the hate, come on, man. We at 30 right now.
Yeah, we're up to 30. 30 accusers.
30 accusers. Tell me why, when one accuser comes, everybody else comes. One accuser came for Cosby, everybody else come. R. Kelly, everybody else come. Mystical, everybody else come. It's the surroundings, man, that they had, that the surroundings that they kept. It's all an inside job. It's like, well, I don't have nothing else to give you no more. So now it's like, well, you gonna give me something. Because you ain't just going to kick me to the curb. I've been living luxury and lavishly for the last 3, 5, 7 years. And now you telling me that you got nothing else for me? So now it's like, okay, well, listen. Well, we going to play this game together now, then. Because I need to continue on living lavishly, luxury. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
I'm not even saying that's the case, but it's like, come on, man. Now we at a count of 30. Come on. 30. Yeah,
we're up to 30. And the scary thing is, you know, we just had this issue with Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart just fired one of his closest boys because Kevin Hart allowed his friend, he trusted him, and his friend charged up over $1 million on a credit card. And it's the same thing. If he had asked for those Nikes, I'm pretty sure Kevin Hart would have gave his boy those Nikes for doing whatever he does for him behind the scenes. But what happens is, it's like you said, people get a certain way and then they decide, well, this is what I'm going to do.
I enjoy stuff like this because it helps me before my career takes off. Mm. Now, regardless, I mean, I'm an independent artist and I'm looking forward to staying independent. But what I'm saying is, I look at a lot of situations. I look at situations like R. Kelly's situation. I look at Mystical's situation, the Cosby, Tiny and T.I.'s situation. I look at Pop Smoke's situation, King Von, Nipsey. I look at all them situations and I say to myself, it was all the company they kept. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, my circle, this over here, man, it's only four chairs that sit at this table, man, and all. I mean, it might be another, I mean, you might could stand up a little bit, but this circle over here, man, small, man, because I ain't got time for nobody to be around me. Like, okay, Goonie's on that situation. Let me take the credit card, go run that up, but we not going to do all that. You know what I'm saying? No, we going to keep this small. Like, No. You know what I'm saying? And not saying that things can't happen, because things can happen. But what I'm saying is, if you just keep it to a minimum, it won't be too much noise, man. It won't be too many worries. So you look at T.I. and Tiny, man. They red carpet events, all types of friends and everything. Like, there's no friends in business. Business is business. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All that building all types of relationships and everything. Nah, man. Hey, listen. When Goonie gets on, right, it's going to be very hard to get in touch with Goonie, man. You know what I'm saying? Can we get in touch with Obama right now?
We ain't going to see you hemmed up at TMZ at the airport talking about somebody talking about this and somebody talking about that. You're going to be like, nah, man, I got my four circle and that's it. That person was sick. They were outside the ring.
Hey, listen, if anything gets leaked, right, I'll look at the couple motherfuckers that's at the table. That's it. I ain't got to go back to the big mansion house and be like, well, how did they know that I was going to go over there or over there? Don't get me wrong. Things that happen. I'm an artist. I'm a street artist. I'm a controversy artist. So things going to happen. I'm aware of that. But what I'm saying is, you also got to be aware of your surroundings and the mm-hmm. people that you're dealing with. You know what I'm saying? I mean, see, I pay more attention now because I don't do the loyalty and love thing no more, man. To me, it ain't no such thing as loyalty and love. We just match your energy levels. That's all we doing. Mm. All that's out the window. I've been in a few situations where the loyalty wasn't loyalty and the love wasn't love. You know what I'm saying? So we just matching energy levels, man. You know, that's all we doing.
Mm. And that's a good way. I like how you said, and I like how you said, you know, it's the people that you keep around you. And then, and like I said, T.I. and Tiny thought they was in a good place, and now they've got these 30 accusations. So we'll see. We'll see what's going to happen there, because it's pretty crazy stuff. I got some pictures to run up real quick for you guys. Godzilla versus Kong is coming out March 31st. It's heading up fast. I'm going to get these over to you guys real quick. This is the first Veana Godzilla vs. Kong, the latest trailer. Here's the second one for you guys, featuring Kong with that Godzilla axe.
Straight out the trenches.
Pretty excited for that. I can't wait. So again, for those who are big Godzilla vs. Kong fans,
straight out the trenches, I would say that I would never win. Jumped off the porch and I ain't.
A special screening preview in Randolph Cinemas. It's going to be 20 of my closest friends to check out this Godzilla versus Kong movie. I can't wait. I am ecstatic. Moving on to the sports booth, Patriots reacquire Pro Bowl Trent Brown. He's coming back, and they're bringing a Pro Bowl offensive tackle back to this team. Guess what that means, people? I'm pretty sure that means they're getting a quarterback. They're going to get a quarterback. I'm telling you, it's coming during the draft. That's the best time to do it. And I'm there for the Patriots. Let's go. Let's get this back on track. Also in the sports booth, Amanda Nunes. She submitted Anderson in the first round, UFC 259. Amanda has now tied Ronda Rousey's holding down that belt. So let's see what happens with her and how she continues on, because she is a beast. Moving on into Biden bombshells. Biden's dogs are going to be returned to the White House after a biting incident. For those who don't know, President Joe Biden has these two rescued German shepherds. One of them is, I think it's only like a year and a half old, but the year and a half old pup bit someone who was a stranger. To be honest, that's better than friggin' Secret Service, man. You got loyal dogs. Your dogs are going to protect you. And that's exactly what a dog is supposed to do. It's supposed to protect their master. So I'm not hating on Joe Biden's dogs. I'm not here to cancel them. It looks like they will be back in the White House after this incident. Also, in Biden's bombshells, rocket attack hits Iraqi airbase with U.S. troops. At this time, there were no casualties reported. But we're going to see what Lloyd Austin does. He's the new Secretary of Defense. I can't wait to see. Also, shout out from the rooftops. $1.9 trillion COVID bill is one step away from passing and getting that Joe Biden signature. $1,400 checks going out to stimulus. I know that first 600 came out there, and you know I did something positive with the money and built a computer tower with that first stimulus. You know, a lot of people you heard, they went out and did some things that they should have done. A lot of people, you know, I know a lot of artists. There are some artists who took the stimulus money and put that money into projects and got money, you know, put to me, that's the right thing to do. Put it into a project. You didn't have that 600 bucks around? Put that into a project. Put it into merchandise. I told some people, you know, get merchandise going. I know Veana Marie, she did the same thing. You know, she worked on getting merchandise and things of that sort. Anything you want to say? Because there's a lot of people out there, a lot of artists are looking to this, and, you know, some people are trying to get their shine on. Would you agree with the same thing? This is a time, when you get something like this, this is your time to put into your craft.
I mean, definitely, because you got to invest in your career, man. You got to, you gotta invest in yourself. So, I mean, if there's artists that was having trouble getting into studios, maybe you might want to invest in some studio equipment and go to Barnes & Noble's, get you a few books to gain some knowledge, or go on YouTube and gain some knowledge and stuff. Because even myself, I started a few days ago, I started looking at some tutorials on YouTube on how to engineer.
Yeah, it's crazy. The information that's out there is crazy.
The information is definitely right there, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, as far as other artists go, I mean, if a stimulus come your way, I mean, yo, merchandise is definitely popping, man. I've been on the merchandise game for years, man, and that wave is popping. I mean, you could just go, you could double your money back, whatever. I mean, just get out there. You know what I'm saying? Get out there and show people what you got, man. I mean, just do something positive. For those that's getting, you know, for those, not even just the artists, for those that's getting this $1,400 stimulus check and whatever you go get for your child or whatever the case may be. If you're just getting a stimulus check, right, just do something positive. And right now, what I would say to everybody in the world, invest in something with that. They passing out this free money for a reason, man. They trying to tell people something, man. So it's like, invest. Invest so that you can see more money, because it's going to get hard. It's going to get hard. They're going to make it hard out here for everybody.
They're going to make it real hard. And I'm going to let people know that. So here's one of the things that I've been talking to people about, and people don't understand. So we've got this cat that came on the show, Eric Young. He's come up with this speaker system that is called Audios. It's a speaker system that runs wirelessly, but it doesn't run on Wi-Fi. It doesn't run on Bluetooth. This is for performers and DJs. It's going to change the game. He's been in Forbes magazine. What he's doing right now till April 30th, and I'll be playing the ad, is he's allowing people to put $100 down into his stock before he gets to Shark Tank and these big money people can start investing. This has never been done before for people in our community. So if you put $100 into that stock and it's $1 a share, you got 100 shares at that $100 when it goes public. It's kind of a no-brainer. The thing is here is Eric Young, he is the CEO, he is the founder, and he is the inventor. This is the first time we've ever had a black person that is all three, plus he is also the owner of the 7 patents that's on this product, Audios, that we'll be showing. And it's one of these things that you say, you know, we need to invest. We have to invest. And here's the thing, people, that people don't realize. A lot of people are pushing and talking about raising the minimum wage to $15 an hour. And, you know, a lot of Trump supporters and people like that were all angry and mad. Here's the thing about the $15 an hour, once they do put that into place, people don't realize that once they put everybody the $15 an hour minimum wage, it raises your tax bracket, your income bracket up. And what happens is a lot of the things that people are getting, from food supplements to housing supplements. Once you make $15 an hour and you're not making $8 an hour no more, guess what? You're going to lose a lot of those benefits. And like Goonie just said, you're going to be having to work your money, invest your money, and do positive things with your money because it's coming quick. It's coming real quick, people. You need to pay attention, like I said, because once everybody goes to $15 an hour, you're not going to be in that certain bracket anymore for housing and food and all that stuff. So pay attention, people, because when it hits, that's what actually happened in Seattle. Seattle put everything to $15 an hour.
Why not invest in something that costs you a couple hundred dollars for you to spend when you receive it just to get it all back? It's a no-brainer.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely a no-brainer. It's not a losing situation at all. But that's just the business side of things. You know, that a lot of artists don't like to share with each other, but I'm sharing.
There you go. So what I want to do is I'm going to let you put your social, because we're at the top. We actually went a little bit over, but we did have that late start because we had the streaming issue. So I want you to put all your social media out there so how people know how they can get in touch with you on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Put that all out there, where they can get your music from.
Hey, real simple, real brief. SoundCloud, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Clubhouse, Goonie Goo, 2 times. That's all.
All right, cool. And I know your rep is actually in the chat, Tay1. He's in the chat. If he can drop that one link in the chat that links everybody, that'd be great, man. That'd be peace if you could do that. So,
okay. You said drop the link?
Yeah, drop the link in the chat. I just told him to drop a link to the chat to your whatever your main one is, and everybody can get in there, and we can go from okay. there. So, upcoming shows, before we get out of here, anything coming up that we can check you at?
Upcoming shows, let's book these flights. We're going down to a mansion party, 3-day show event down in Orlando with Uncle Luke. Goonie Goo 2 times is up on there performing live 3 days straight, man.
Hold up. 2 live crew, Uncle Luke?
Uncle Luke, that's right. The boss of Florida right there. Mm. So, it's a mansion party. It's a mansion party for Black Diva, Marlowe's magazine. They're having a seafood barbecue. The next day is a barbecue. Then the next day after that, it's a dinner. And all 3 days, it's a show event. And Goonie's performing all 3 days. So if anybody wanna take a trip to Orlando, man, and go jump in the pool, have a barbecue, and hang out, and watch Goonie perform live. Hey, listen, I got 10 tickets, man, and right now I haven't even broadcasted too much about that. So if anybody's looking to roll out, man, April 9th to April 13th, let's go. That's in Orlando, Florida. March 27th, I skipped the date, but on March 27th, this month here, I'm in Maryland, red carpet event for modeling search for models to attend a show that's being held in Baltimore the second week of May, which is Goonie. I'm the headliner of this show in Baltimore. They made me the headliner, so they called me in to help pick out the models. So not just that, these models is gonna be wearing my clothing.
Oh, there you go.
Yes, I do my own t-shirts, my own sweaters, my own everything. I got boys shorts for females, panties for females. I got it all. So I'll be in B-more in 2 weeks for this red carpet event, and that's what's going on right now. On May 5th, Trapman's drop after May 5th. The last week of May, Goonie's on tour, 5-city, 5-state tour that I put together myself. If there's any artists that would love to be part of that or anything, holler at me. Let me know. I ain't got no problem with breaking bread. I mean, I just be skeptic. But, you know, if the energy levels is matching, then we good.
There you go. There you go. All right, so we're going to get ready to head out of here, close out the show. For those of you looking at this down below, the Sinister One beanies are in effect. I got to give big thanks to everybody who's been buying the Sinister One Productions beanie hats and stuff, man. The LLC for me is killing. One. Yeah, we got to do a swap. We got to do a swap. I'll get you a beanie.
Well, yep.
Yeah, we got to do a swap and take that picture, man. Get you in that beanie, boy. That'd be ill. So, yeah, because as anybody who gets a picture with me in the beanie, as you guys can see, DJ Bobby Steels, I got my barber right there, Veana Marie, UFC fighter Peter Barrett rocking the beanie. So, I'm going to, look, Kevin Jeffries, host the Happy Hour with Lito, Matt Cameron, Happy Hour Sports with Matty C, you and me, Travis Partington, Oscar Mike Radio, Veana Marie rocking the beanie. So, I'm going to have to link up with Goonie. And I could get some of Goonie's gear and get Goonie and Sinister One Productions beanie and get him up on there and be able to appreciate him.
Well, let's make this happen this week, man, because I don't like to talk about nothing. Let's make it happen.
Yeah. I'm actually free on Thursday. I'm not lying. Look, I just picked up the bike today out the shop, got it ready for spring. I'm going to have the motorcycle out on Thursday. I'm working tomorrow and taking Thursday off, and I'm going to be out on the motorcycle Thursday. So let's hook up. We can make that swap and make that happen and get that picture up and going, because there's still some warm weather. You're going to still need that chilly weather still out here in the morning. So yeah, we'll definitely link up.
It's cold. Colorado, man. It's cold over there.
Right, you know, so we'll hook up after that. So, hey, I got to thank everybody for tuning in the show. Don't forget, Ray Royale is going to be on this show next week. Some smooth R&B type music. Also, Shay Cotton, anybody who watches basketball, Shay Cotton is a story that everybody needs to watch. And most people who know basketball, look, I seen Shay Cotton play in 95. He was a high school kid. He was coming up with Kevin Garnett, and he was probably the best high school baller in the nation. The story that happened to this man is something that you all got to watch and see and hear about. The movie is called Manchild. The Shay Cotton story is real. When you have guys like Randy Moss, Paul Pierce, all in this film talking about Shay Cotton, this is a show, people, you ain't going to want to miss this show. As we said, we have the live chat, so you can jump in the chat with questions for Shay Cotton. But this man was the ultimate baller. He was the LeBron James and the Kobe Bryant before there was Kobe's and LeBron's. He was the high school student that was selling out gyms before anybody. And the story that happened to him is one of the most craziest stories in the history of NBA. So you want to tune in on March 30th for that show. If you're around Goonie, love to have you in the chat for that show, because that's gonna be a good show.
Hey, listen, right, just tag me in, man. If I ain't busy, I'm tuned in, man.
Yeah, this is gonna be a good show. Anybody who likes basketball, this is the show. So hey, I want to thank everybody for coming on here, hanging out with us tonight. It was a good ass show. I'm gonna get you guys my ad from Audios, who is now a sponsor of the booth. Eric Young is the CEO and the founder, and he is the inventor of this great product. And after that, people, it'll be SpongeBob Take Us Home. But again, Goonie Goo, thank you for coming on the show. The single is Till They Come and Get Me. You want to hit that up, SoundCloud, hit them up on all the social media, Goonie Goo 2 times. Here's the ad for Audios, and then it'll be SpongeBob Take Us Home. Peace.
At Audios, our engineers have created a breakthrough in wireless loudspeakers. We developed a new way to experience sound. Audios, the future of loudspeakers.
Hi, I'm Eric Young, the co-founder and CEO of Audios, and we're building the first fully wireless loudspeakers for venues and event spaces.
With Audios, all you have to do is place the speakers where you want them and press the power button. The speakers automatically build their own wireless network, connect to each other, and start streaming. That means you have zero cables and zero cable replacements. A 300-person event that would take 1 hour to set up only takes 10 minutes with Audios. Our wireless speaker doesn't need Bluetooth, a Wi-Fi router, and has 2 patents granted. To learn more, go to republic.co/audios. For a limited time only, anyone can invest and become a part owner.
Well, see you next Tuesday.
Thank you for listening to The Booth on Hoobazoo and HatcherRadio.com. Please follow the Facebook page and subscribe to the podcast at Apple Podcast, iHeartRadio, and Spotify. The Booth is a Sinister One production hosted by Sinister One.
I've got to start hanging out with friends that are a little more intelligent and understand politics and stuff. It's just that I'm up on this level up here, and all my friends are down here. Me, meh. You guys, meh. Maybe a little more down in here. Screw you guys, I'm going home.
I smoke, I drink, I do my thing. These bitches hating, so you know I gots to make it plain. Don't do cocaine with your chick, my main. We stick together, true forever, yeah, you know we bang. I miss those days, which was easy. If only I make it, bitch, don't repeat. Now that I done upgraded, I've been upstate, but y'all think I'm playing. And I got a hit now for these weak ass hoes who think I ain't slaying. Try me, and I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out.
W-H-O-O-B-A-Z-O-O, that's Hoobazoo.com.
Enter website, enter website, enter website, enter website.